Welcome
to Munda Makeover.
We have traveled all over Zambia to find hardworking farmers.
We want to share their success stories
and where there are challenges, we will bring experts to help them gain the extra knowledge they need
so they can adapt and make their farms more productive even while the climate changes.
We want to support them to get better yields
and increase their income.
We will see how farmers from across the country can benefit from our experts' advice
while also learning from each other in so many ways.
Join us on these journeys and share in the farmers' experiences as they improve their farms
on
Munda Makeover.
So, Cozy, what do you love most about farming?
Although it's a lot of hard work, it's quite fun.
Is it a lot of fun? I thought it's just about a lot of hard work.
No, come on, Vikacha. Tell me, which job allows you to walk into your office, pick fresh food and eat it? Or better still, take a little investment, as small as one seed, and after 3 months, it's multiplied into 100 seeds.
Wow, that's true.
Yeah. So, what do you like most about farming?
That I get to tell my silly jokes. Like, what's the cow's favorite show?
What?
Munda Makeover!
A retired teacher, Aidah Tembo, is a passionate, well-organized, and eager to learn farmer. That is why we have traveled to Kankantapa in Chongwe to see her.
I used to teach at a secondary school. All along, I've had that passion for farming. I was a weekend farmer. I plant my maize, plant my soya, go back.
Okay.
Even where I was in town, I used to keep chickens. I prepared myself psychologically. Then after I retired in 2018, I started farming. I came to the farm. The size of the farm is about 4 hectares.
Let's see if she's home.
Yeah,
Odi,
not long.
You are welcome. Komo. How are you?
My name is Vikasha.
Vikasha, glad to meet you.
Good morning. My name is Koziani.
I'm Aidah Piri Tembo.
A rainy morning.
Yes, it has been raining.
But we do know that we've been struggling with a very dry season, unfortunately.
Yes.
What exactly do you farm?
Yes.
Here, I farm vegetables.
Ah, fantastic.
Okay. I also have chickens.
Ah, fantastic.
Village and broiler chickens.
Both.
I also have goats.
Did you attempt to grow any maize or
Yes, during this rain season, I did.
Okay. How big was the portion of maize that you planted?
2 hectares.
2 hectares.
Yes.
And how has it fared?
Because of the drought, the heat, no rains, pests. Armyworms.
I'm sorry to hear that.
So what we are going to do is get the experts, bring them for you so they can offer the possible solutions for your farm to flourish and so for you to remain beautiful.
Sure.
Waste no time. We'll see you shortly.
Please.
And,
don't go and go forever. The others
will
come like this when they go.
Now.
Okay, bye.
Come on, let's get up.
As women, we can and we should also make decisions on the farm. What to plant, when to plant, market, insurance. Being close to the household gives us an insight into the most important needs. We are part of the team. And as always, teamwork wins. We have called in Dr. Emma Stambuli, our partner in matters of gender, to teach us more on the role of women in farming.
We've come to your farm to learn about how you are managing your farm. You are a widow and you are working on your own. So we want to look at the presence of a man and when you are working on your own.
Yes. I really miss the presence of my husband because some of these things, the drip lines, even the tank, everything, he did that.
He did that.
Yes. But now, the maintenance. of the drip pipes, uh-huh. the finances, mm-hmm. It wasn't easy. Mm-hmm. Even dealing with the workers, yes. it was so easy with the man around.
When he passed on, didn't you have the desire to go back to town?
We buried, I think, a few days. I said, am I going back? It would be very difficult for me. I just gathered courage. So I said, my mother is old. I'm going to get my mother. At least she'll keep me company.
Okay.
So I came here. With the little finances we're getting from the vegetables, from the tomatoes, I'll plow back. Mm. Then I had poultry. I think psychologically, I prepared myself.
Nice.
Okay. Good. So what support system did you have outside the farm that strengthened you, that helped you settle down?
Truthfully speaking, the kankantapa community, they've been there with me.
Mm-hmm. Now, as a woman and alone, how are you coping with the situation of dealing with
supervising
the workers?
Them.
Yes, market.
One thing what I've learned, you know, workers, be firm with them, but be also close to them.
Nice.
As they know a lot, also have a listening ear.
Yeah.
I've learned a lot.
Okay.
Truthfully speaking, it hasn't been easy. No. I would wake up early in the morning, book a counter, maybe around 01, 02. Yes, you take your chickens to Chongwe, you go and sell, you come back, sometimes you haven't sold very well, you are depressed, then I say, no. There's nothing like that. Let me move on.
I'm sure this farm has grown.
Yes, it has.
Yes,
yes, so it has.
What has really helped you succeed?
Mm-hmm. Discipline first.
Okay, so disciplined.
Mm-hmm. Financially, yes. I never used to use money anyhow.
Mm-hmm.
I sacrificed all the town life I had. I got used to eating what is available.
Mm-hmm.
Even social-wise, you should be disciplined.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you take a bit of wine, but you say no, not this time. Let me work.
Enough.
The nice clothes, the makeup, the hair, the water.
So you had to forego all those.
Everything. This shouldn't be a drawback.
Mm-hmm. After losing her husband, Aidah faced some challenges in her farming, finding that she sometimes had to be firm with the workers. Part of the community also challenged her ability as a woman. But she overcame them, proving that a woman can run a successful farm. Now the whole community is behind her. We can learn from this and realize that with access to the same resources as men, women make great farmers too.
How are you learning how to grow these crops?
You know, you can't stay alone in farming. Mm-hmm. You have to interact with others. Mm. Even the administration, they have been very helpful.
Mm-hmm.
On WhatsApp, there are so many groups. I'm in vegetable group, I'm in poultry group.
Mm-hmm.
Women should join the agricultural groups.
Mm-hmm.
And through reading, that's why reading is very, very important.
Very important.
Yes. How many meals should we put in a knapsack? All that.
Yeah.
I'm able to read. Mm-hmm. And learn to ask. Don't think you know it all, no.
Yeah.
The way we used to look at a woman is very different now. And here is a clear example of a woman who's able to manage things differently and very, very well. We've been learning from her experience. She's joined several groups where she's learning. She's also reading, also in touch with the neighborhood. So all that is helping her succeed. The poultry, there's vegetables, the fruits.
Okay, yes. You spoke about the fruits. Maybe we should go to the garden and have
and
some.
Have some.
Aidah is hardworking and has really done a lot to ensure her farm is productive and organized. But she also faces challenges. With the current dry conditions, with no maize on the farm, chicken farming is an important alternative for her income. Unfortunately, her chicken run really needs some work, so she didn't keep broilers this season. And that's where we come in. By making over her chicken run, she can tend to both village and broiler chickens when the rains fell.
Imagine working very hard, clearing your field, preparing the soil, planting seeds, weeding, adding fertilizer, and then someone just comes and eats up all your hard work. That's exactly what pests do.
Climate change is real. The fall armyworm has really affected my maize. More than 3/4 has been wasted. The drought plus 4 armyworms. I don't think we'll reach June. I won't have any maize by June.
pests and diseases can cause big losses to a farmer. The Zambia Agricultural Research Institute, ZARI, has been working on various ways to protect our crops. Mrs. Tembo from ZARI will tell us more on the simple ways a smallholder farmer like Aidah can carry out to manage the fall armyworm.
What have you been able to observe from the field?
The first thing I saw was fall armyworm attack.
Wow.
The attack is severe in the sense that most of the leaves are eaten up.
Wow.
Again, I've seen drought. Mm-hmm. When I looked at this maize, I've seen that fall armyworm is still there. You can see that is a fall armyworm larva.
Oh, wow. How did it end up here?
In Zambia, we noticed it in 2016.
Okay.
As ZARI, we started carrying out surveys.
Mm-hmm.
We found out that it is everywhere, in all the provinces.
Having seen how widespread and damaging the fall armyworm is, ZARI started finding solutions.
The first one, we started planting our maize seed, regardless of what variety. We were testing what date, what time can be good for us to plant maize.
Okay.
So that we fight this fall armyworm. Right now, we are promoting early planting at the beginning of the rains. As you are planting early, encourage your neighboring farmers to also join you in their fields. They start planting at the same time with you.
How is this going to affect or help us prevent the fall armyworm?
Immediately we start planting maize, they will start leaving wherever they are. The smell of maize, where they are, they start looking at it. So if we encourage you to plant with the neighbors, when they come, they'll be confused. There is maize, there is maize, there is maize. They don't even know where to start eating from. They are overwhelmed. By the time they're saying, where can I start from? Maize is also growing. They attack maize, which is at tender stage with tender leaves.
I see.
So we are encouraging you, plant with your neighbors at the same time.
So that's strategy number one, early planting.
Early planting.
What else can we look at?
We are encouraging you also to start checking, scouting your maize fields as early as 7 days after germination.
Okay.
Make it twice per week, at least for the first 6 weeks. Then as you are scouting, destroy any egg masses or fall armyworm larva found on your maize.
Okay.
So just do this tenderly, not to disturb the chlorophyll. You know, the fall armyworm has got a soft-bodied.
Right.
So any disturbance, you have killed it.
I see.
You know, ZARI is looking at a small-scale farmer. How many hectares do you plant?
I normally plant 2 hectares.
She can have workers because that one is cheaper than we start looking for the chemical. Have you seen? It's not the whole plant.
Indeed.
It's just a few
areas
of them
that have been affected.
Yes.
Okay.
That can be easier for you to do that.
Fantastic.
As ZARI, we've tested indigenous methods. This is ash.
Mm-hmm.
You sieve, then bring it to this level.
Powdery.
It's powdery.
Yes. Right.
Yes. Then if our maize, as young as 1 week, you find fall armyworm is there, you come and start adding on the maize funnel. Make sure that you don't cover completely. At least leave a part so that maize is breathing. 3 days or 4 days from now, you start coming out. It is passing and its body is soft.
Mm-hmm.
In ash, there is alkaline.
Yes.
So the alkaline is osmosis.
Right.
So alkaline is entering into its body.
Okay.
Sometimes you can find it dead, hanging here.
It will dry up.
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
What other methods can we use, especially if our small-scale farmer is now thinking of expanding onto maybe bigger pieces of land?
Let's come to neem leaf extract. I think looking at this, you know this.
Yes.
This is a neem tree.
Yes.
Leaves.
Yes.
You pluck a lot of leaves, then hold them like this.
Okay.
I think that will translate to 2 kgs.
Okay.
You get them, you pound them, but of course you do this.
You take them off the stems.
So after pounding, put your neem paste in a 10-liter container of water and mix. Let it sit for 24 hours. Then sieve using a clean cloth to get the neem extract. Pour in a knapsack and spray your maize aiming directly into the funnel.
I'm very, very happy because I've already grown neem, so it's just pounding, as simple as all that.
That's why we are saying to our farmers, plant neem tree. Mm. Have it like the way Mrs. Yes. Tembo has it.
And if all the above methods fail, then the farmer can go to a certified agrovet, get a chemical recommended by the agrovet, and spray the maize. As Aidah fights pests on her garden, we're hard at work making sure her chicken run is finished on time. We need to clean it thoroughly. Then the window curtains go up, which will help in maintaining good temperatures and give a stress-free environment for the chicks. Mrs. Tembo has been growing maize as her main crop, but the yield is not looking so good. So, how can we help? Well, with the help of our friends in the graphics department here on Munda Makeover, we are preparing a special video to show you how. Maize is one of Zambia's favorite crops, but if it's grown too often in the same field, pests multiply. Diseases spread more quickly, and the soil can run out of the nutrients the crop needs to grow strong and healthy. So, what's the solution? Well, crop rotation is very important. Never plant the same crop in the same soil as the season before. But what we want to discuss today is a companion technology, strip cropping. That is, planting alternating rows of different plants side by side. Let's see how to strip crop maize. First, which plants make the best companions? Maize is a plant that loves nitrogen. The more it gets, the stronger it grows, and the bigger the cobs it produces. Fertilizers, however, are expensive, and chemical fertilizers can have a long-term impact on soil health. The solution: plant a crop next to the maize that feeds the maize, that is, it fixes nitrogen in the soil. No need for so much fertilizer. Typically, these are legumes and include pigeon pea, groundnuts, soybeans, and cowpeas. And not only will they help improve the soil, they produce their own delicious food crops as well. It's a win-win. Now, having chosen our plants, we need to know how to plant them. Many farmers simply plant alternating rows. The problem with this method is that if the plants are too close together, they compete. One can end up shedding the other from sunlight. And then timing is also important. If legumes are planted at the same time as the maize, they might steal too many nutrients from each other, leaving one or both stunted. To find out how best to strip crop, CIMIT, the International Maize and Wheat Improvement Center, spent many years experimenting to find out the best techniques. And today, we are going to bring you two variations that were both proved to work very well. First, double row strip cropping. In this system, two rows of maize are alternated with three rows of legumes. The two rows of maize should be planted 50 centimeters apart. The in-row spacing for maize and should be 25 centimeters from plant to plant. Plant two seeds and thin for one. The legumes should have total space of 130 centimeters per strip, with either two or three rows evenly spaced depending on the crop chosen. If you choose pigeon pea, plant two rows with 50 centimeters between each row and 40 centimeters between the pigeon pea and the maize on either side. If you choose cowpea, groundnut, or beans, then plant three rows with 35 centimeters between each row and 30 centimeters between the last row and the maize on the other side. The in-row spacing for the legumes should be 30 centimeters from plant to plant. The total width then for the maize and legume strips combined will be 180 centimeters. In the next growing season, follow the crop rotation principles and swap the planting sites. The improved light axis of two-row cropping will actually increase yield over the single-row cropping system. Now, this is all very well, but what if you wanted to use mechanization on the farm? Tractors, maybe? Well,
The scientists at CIMID discovered that although mechanization is possible with two-row strip cropping, a maize legume strip crop of four rows maize alternating with four rows of legumes is easier to implement and also preferred by farmers as weeding is more convenient. When planting four-row strip cropping, the combined strip width is 3 cm with 4 rows of maize planted 45 cm apart on one side, totaling 180 cm, and 4 rows of legumes planted 45 cm apart on the other side, also totaling 180 cm. The in-row spacing for the maize should be 25 cm from plant to plant. Plant 2 seeds and thin for 1. The in-row spacing for the legumes should be 30 cm from plant to plant. In the next growing season, follow the crop rotation principles of conservation agriculture as before, swapping the maize and the legume planting rows. So, that's it. If you follow these recommendations, you can save on inputs like fertilizers. You will have more variety of food to harvest, which will help against the unpredictable effects of climate change, and you will provide a greater range of healthy food for the family. All this, and you will have a bumper harvest.
Munda makeover. You know, you have put a smile on my face. So I'm very, very grateful. I've learned a lot. I'll share with my friends. You know, knowledge is sharing. Let me not keep it to myself, because I can't feed the whole world alone.
Next, we're going to look at the weather.
Welcome to Munda Makeover, Drought Special for Zambia. Because of climate change, we expect dry conditions to continue across Zambia, with few areas getting good rains. Drought is one of the most disastrous climate-related threats that affects agriculture, the environment, infrastructure, and socio-economic activities. With the current dry condition across the country, ensure to practice conservation farming, which includes digging where you want to plant your seed only and not the entire farm. Covering the soil with dry grass or leaves to help retain water in the soil, and planting cover crops. If you have access to water for irrigation, consider planting early maturing maize varieties and other alternative crops such as early maturing legumes and vegetables to cope with the impacts of dry spells. Consider making silage from maize that has no chance of recovering to feed your livestock in this dry season. Preserve fodder so that you may have enough food for your livestock, as pasture might not be enough this year. Scout your farm for pests and control them as soon as you spot them with the recommended pesticides. Report any unusual insects or crop diseases to the nearest agricultural office. If your area gets rain, collect water from your roof to your storage points such as tanks and drums. Ensure to clean your roof and gutters to get clean water. Preserve food by sun drying, salting, and fermenting for use throughout the dry season. Destock your livestock and keep those you are able to care for properly. You can restock when normalcy returns. Now is the best time to use non-farm rural activities such as crop production to earn income. For further assistance and information, contact the nearest agricultural officer.
A few final steps and the chicken run will be done. We layer the floor with wood shavings. We have to ensure it's thick enough to absorb moisture and the smell in the chicken house. Make sure to remove any sharp objects or plastics. Finally, it is time to disinfect the run. Remember to start at the top, coming down, disinfecting even the wood shavings. This will keep away diseases from our chicks. After this, the chicken run will stay empty for a few days before the chicks come in.
Munda makeover has changed my chicken run. I love it. It's looking nice. It's wonderful. And knowing broilers, they love neatness. and fresh air ventilation.
Yeah, Mrs. Tembo. Yeah. So that's it for this week, but we'll see you next week
on another episode of
Munda Makeover.
Thank you.